Hi, I'm Paul Roberts, and I've got to get this video out of the way before I'm not caffeinated anymore. No, just kidding. I'm Paul Roberts, and this is Conscious Counseling 101. This is about how to realize you have no problems, how to get past all your problems. Yes, how do you do that? Is it a special spell that you cast? No. What it is just simply this. You learn to view every single thing that's happening to you in the most positive way it could possibly be viewed. There's probably a few problems you can't possibly get past. We're not gonna talk about those today. Let's just forget about those right now. We're talking about generally almost all your problems can go away by simply having the right perspective. I try to help you to understand how you can use your mind and use your perspective and the counseling I provide through perspective counseling to see anything that you're grappling with in a completely different way to the point where you can take it and make it so it's something that you're not even bothered by anymore. Yeah, it's still the same thing. Oh, it's still the same thing. It's still got all the ramifications that it's got and everything like that. But you won't see, if you do this well, the ramifications as absolutely as negatively as you do currently. You can get past your problems by simply seeing a different point of view that I can help you to gain. It's not delusional. It's just something that you might not have considered. Somebody outside of your life can help you to do that. Because you're grappling with something that every day you say, I'm not getting anywhere. I just don't understand what I should do personally. All your comfort group, all your obstacles are all the same, all the peers that you have, all your circumstances in life are the same. And as long as those things are the same, unless you bust out of what you're doing, well, you know, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again, but expecting different results. I can help you to understand what you're doing in your particular set of circumstances and what instead you could be doing. You don't have to listen to what I say, but you could consider it. Hey, right now you don't have it. Why don't you at least ask for it? I offer counseling of perspective nature. I offer a way to take, I'm an artist, I take what I see and I work with it and I manipulate it and I represent it. And when I do that, what it does is it allows for you, the recipient, to see something that you didn't see prior. And if I take everything that I've got to work with and I give it to you on a platter, you can see whether or not you think any of those things can help you. This video is about getting past all your problems. What you need to do to get past all your problems is see them as something other than a problem. I don't mean to belittle you if you're really suffering and grieving, or you're in pain, or you've really got something that is maybe beyond what I can help you with. I don't mean to belittle you, but if it's anything else that's common to humanity throughout all time, you can get past those things by learning the lessons that life can teach you. The Socratic lessons of knowing yourself, learning from life, being a student of the things that are, and taking what you learn and applying it back into your life. The first thing, obviously, most people come to me about is problems. How do I get past problems? Well, they're going to have to do all the work, right? But one of the things that I do is I say, well, have you considered looking at the things that you're calling problems in a different way? Have you considered that they're only problems if you want an outcome that doesn't look like those will allow you to have? They're really maybe not even problems, but they're problems because they seem like obstacles or barriers to keep you from getting what you'd like to have. What you could do is you could alter your point of view of what you'd like to have to see if you can get around those things. But if you can't, you can alter how you approach the tack that you take to life. And by doing so, you may find that those things that were problems fall away. Because as you put more positive energy in the tack that you now want to take in life, all of a sudden, the obstacles that were in your way from the tack you were taking are no longer in your way because you're taking a different tack. I'm not saying you need to give up on all the things you want. I'm saying there are many, probably infinite roads to the same place. But let's not assume that your same place is really all that valuable. Let's assume there are other places too. Let's use non-linear, out-of-the-box thinking. Let's think about where we think we want to go. Let's analyze it. Let's analyze all the different ways that there are to possibly go towards that direction. And as we become heightened consciously aware, utilize all the new perceptions that are coming into us as we go down that tact to that place, to not only navigate it, but to continually reevaluate where we could be going and whether we should be going there, whether there's any real value or the greatest value for us there in the first place. Conscious Counseling 101 looks at the whole of the perspective, looks at the whole of what you hold, what you're going towards, what you want, what you're desirous of. Conscious Counseling 101 will help you to evaluate every action you take, every way you see something with your perspective that you currently have, and allow you to have tools that will give you new ways of having perspective and evaluating what is good in the first place. You want to get over vices or things that hold you back? Why do you do them? There's got to be a good reason, right? Or you wouldn't do it. And even if it's just satisfaction or I don't know what else to do, that's okay, fine. How do you know that what you'd be going for if you threw that away and you got what you wanted would be more satisfying than the thing that you're doing now for satisfaction? You don't, right? So if you want to stop doing things that are detrimental now that you could consider vices, to become more aware of what it is that you're going towards and what it might bring to you fully, you could become more aware of what that could have as negative impact as well. And when you become more analytical of that, you could weigh it up against what you're doing right now and say, whoa, why am I going towards something else that may have need for artificial vice satisfaction? If I've already got that now and I see it's not really satisfying, why would I want to go towards a target that might also have that in it? And you got to be really honest with yourself, and you got to be really analytical of what the target is and put yourself there and imagine it. Imagine you have it now. Would it all be perfect, or is that a delusion in your mind, a notion, a false notion that doesn't hold water? If it is, you need to spend more time looking at the target while you're, go ahead and go towards it, okay? Use this perspective counseling in the meantime, if you don't believe me about the whole thing and how it works, to go towards it. Just do both things, like I'm saying. Do both things as you're going towards it. Evaluate the thing. Evaluate the circumstances of life. Evaluate how you see them. Evaluate your obstacles. Evaluate your pluses. Evaluate your talents, your skills, and why you want it, and what bogged down things it might be holding you down made you feel like that's what you needed in the first place. All these types of things need to be evaluated, and while you're evaluating them, continue to evaluate the totality of the thing that you see on your distant sights. Place it right here now, as if you have it right now. Look at every nuance of it. Don't think of it as so far away that you can't really look at it in detail. Imagine. Einstein said, imagination is more important than knowledge. Imagine that you have what you want right now. Don't keep thinking of that it's so far off that you don't really have to look like it's right there with you right now. Pretend it is. Imagine that it is. Analyze it so closely. Look at all the ramifications that it can bring. Ask yourself if any of that will bring anxiety, if any of that will bring depression, if any of that will have to be relieved in the same ways that now you're maybe trying to relieve the things that you have that are going on in your life. Ask yourself if there's any possibility of that. It's something to do while you're going along towards it. You can do more things at once than just one. While you keep your eye on the prize, you can figure out how to get there by different ways. You can analyze the prize. You may find that while you're going through life, your perspective will allow you, with these tools that I try to share with you through Conscious Counseling 101, to evaluate everything. You may find that the tools that I can work with you here at Conscious Counseling 101 will help you to do these generalized things that I'm talking about. This is a general video. I'm not talking about everything that we're going to be talking about right now. I'm talking about what we're going to be doing. Your unique set of circumstances are obviously going to have me talk to you in different ways based on whatever it is that you bring to my attention and that you'd like to express your concerns about, obviously. But this video is about how I do what I do and how I help you to do what you'd like to do. This is a more in-depth study of what I am trying to get you to see. And sometimes I ask people for, give me something to work with. Tell me a little bit more about what you'd like me to do. And sometimes it's hard to pull it out. And some people, they think it's all a bunch of hogwash, and they don't even have me try the very first time. Somehow they were feeling down, they had a down moment, and they talk with me, and they say, hey, I'd like you to talk to me about something. And I say, okay, great, great, great. Tell me a little bit about what it is you want me to talk about and how it's affecting you, and I'll start talking with you about it. And sometimes I lose them. They don't even take the time to do that because I don't even want to do that even. Well, you know what? I looked up just the other day other free counseling services. And I said, hey, just for fun, I'm going to pretend like I wanted counseling, like I'm offering. Let's find out what it would be like. I click on the major links to go up at the top of the search engines. You go there, you get a whole bunch of people you could choose from. Say, oh, this person looks interesting. Click on there. Then a whole bunch of questions come along. You answer each one. I did it anyway, just because I wanted to see what would happen. And finally at the end, two major things happen. The first most important thing is this great big disclaimer contract thing that you have to sign that takes all responsibility away from them. So in other words, they put what their concerns are first before yours. I learn from my concerns. I learn from my analysis. And then I take what I've learned and I immediately give it freely. That's just the one thing. The second thing is you have to sign up. You have to have an identity, various social network. I didn't even look at the whole thing of how it all goes. But you have to be kind of come inculcated into the system, so to speak. There's no system here. All I'm trying to do is offer something freely. And occasionally some people say, well, I don't want your general counseling. I want you to have particular service for me. And I say, okay, I can do that, but that's not what I'm trying to do. I will do that if you insist that you don't want this generic, it goes out to everybody to help everybody counseling that I'm trying to do and I have been trying to do for the past 15 years. I don't have to do that for you if you don't want me to, but that's what I try to do. I'm speaking to the person that thinks they have something they're going toward and they're having trouble. Things have bogged them down, caused all kinds of problems in their life. And they just want somebody else outside their scope of people that they currently are hanging out with, or their notions or faulty ideas that have been lumped on them, like all the baggage that we carry through life. And ask me to say, hey, what can you say about what I find myself in? What have you done in your life that you've lifted that off your shoulders? I want to do the same. That's what I do. That's what I'd like to help you with. You don't even have to give me any personal information. You don't have to even tell me anything that equates who you are as opposed to another person. You can just tell me random details. You know, like everybody always says when they go to the doctor, say, hey doc, I got this friend that's got these problems. I got, you know, you've seen that a million times in movies and television shows. That's all you have to do. You just say, hey, I've got these things I want you to talk about. This is what the details are. Speak to that, and I will. It doesn't have to be you. Okay? There's no commitment on your part. There's no contract. There's no cash. There's no payment of any kind. All there is you telling me what you'd like to have me delve into or help you to delve into and how I can help you to understand the prospective challenges that you have and how they can be seen differently, like I've done in my own personal life, and see if you can benefit from it. That's it. And I'm just going to leave this here. That's what I'm asking you to do. And I'll be glad to be there with you as long as I can, every step of the way, to help you to learn from what I've done in my own personal life and that I know I can transfer on to you. I'm Paul Roberts, and this is Conscious Counseling 101.